why are you laughing already? I was trying to give him, I was trying to come strong with it, Kate, and you just threw me in. You just laughed already. Already, it's downhill from here. Well, welcome to Wright at Home. Welcome. Apparently, we have not started on a good foot tonight. Already down. It's already just tanking. I was really just, I took a big deep breath.
We need to have like a turn though, because I never get to welcome.
So. Are you going to come strong with energy?
Not like that.
Well.
Like, I can't do that.
I think you should. Next time. Next
Hello. Time. It's good to see everybody. I gotta be me. I can't be you.
I'm being me, and I'm coming strong.
Can you
strong.
Be me?
That's a negative. Trust me. You don't want me to be you.
What is that supposed to mean?
I don't know.
Anyway.
You're the voice of the people. Based off last week, you're the voice of the people. So,
Okay. According
to last week, you were the voice of the people. So, Okay. Anyways.
Welcome.
We can just sit here and talk.
I know, right.
I don't know for those of you that are watching. Welcome, everybody. Thanks for hanging out with us tonight. We missed a lot of you last week because we had Father's Day, so we didn't get a chance to hang out with you. However, we have breaking news. Big news right now. Straight off the bat, for the first people that are on, you're going to hear the breaking news. Shane Bailey.
Oh.
Because you made me laugh before we even started. Before you started, Shane Bailey, you have won tonight.
Oh.
And because of that, we had somebody that donated their gift card to somebody in Antioch West. So Shane, because you are such a man of faith about being a winner, you can get the $50 gift card that was forfeited. Shane Bailey, you are now the new winner of the Amazon $50 gift card for your faith. So,
congratulations.
Congratulations.
Today, Shane, you won!
Out of the abundance of the heart, mouth speaks that faith you were speaking before we even started. Look at that, man. It already...
Wait, you got to do the...
Yes, where's that? Or the, do we have a... What's the clapping
one? I have no idea.
I don't know these buttons. There we go. There you go. It's clapping. The crowd stands up. Anyways, but hello.
Michelle, hello. And Noraline.
Noraline from Maine. Hello. Thank you for reaching out.
Yes. We're so excited to hear the good news.
Thank you for reaching out. We missed you last week, but thanks for being on. Yes. Hello, Michelle. How are you? Thanks
yes.
for coming
welcome,
on
welcome.
Tonight.
And Tamika.
Tamika's back.
Hello, she's back.
Shane doing his happy dance. I don't even want to know what that is, but we'll just go with it, Shane. I'm glad this is Facebook Live and we cannot see you to know what the happy dance is.
But oh, man. No, I wish we could because I'd like
we
to.
We could video
it,
Shane.
It would be fun to see.
Shane, could we get a video of that? We could play it on the next Ride at Home. Shane's happy dance. Our numbers we would go viral right there.
Oh, absolutely. No question.
It would totally go viral. Mm-hmm. So anyways, Shane, way to stick it in there, buddy. Way to keep confessing.
Mm-hmm.
Paid off. So you're going to get the $50 gift card that was vacated. Hello, New Mexico.
New Mexico, Sister Cheryl.
What's
welcome
up,
back.
Our New Mexico friend? So anyways, that just started with a bang. Shane, in case you missed it, you got to scroll back up. We hadn't even got on for 2 seconds and Shane Bailey was already fired up.
It was great.
Oh God, I hope not, Nick. I really hope not. That would be damaging to all of us mentally, emotionally. So anyways, hello everybody. Welcome. Once you getting on tonight, we missed you last week. It was Father's Day. Hope you all had a good Father's Day. We had fun last week, actually.
We did.
Our kids were on. Noah came strong. Was last week the Spider-Man costume?
Yes, it was.
Wow, that was last week.
Yeah, I know. Ooh. All of the days run together.
It just gets rough here.
I don't
this
know
COVID
if it does
time,
for you guys.
This COVID time stuff is rough. Does anybody feel the time? Just you've lost track of time with COVID. That was last week.
Yeah, it really was.
Wow.
It was.
Where have I been? Shane's happy dance. Shane's happy dance is throwing me off. So anyways, last week we had fun. My son was dressed up as Spider-Man. We had some Father's Day stuff. Had some this or that stuff going on. But we had fun. So tonight, he sent it to me. Shane Bailey, you sent it. I don't know if I have the ability to, I'm going to see if we have the technology here, Shane, to play video. I better preview it, though.
Yes.
Oh, he does. It is. Oh, folks, ladies and gentlemen, this is hot off the press. I don't know if this can be seen. Oh, it can be. Folks, look at that. Shane Bailey is doing his happy dance. Look at that. Oh, it's a short clip, But it was worth it, folks. That was live. Shane Bailey doing his happy dance.
Good job.
He won. Thank you, Shane, for sharing that. And anyways, but real quick, little side note. We won't be on next week. We are going to take the weekend off because it's the holiday. So we will take our first Sunday night off next week for Right at Home. So I hope all of you have a wonderful 4th of July. But we're going to take next Sunday off, and then we're going to come back. We'll be back on the following Sunday, which will be the 12th, I believe. So we won't be next week. So just a little side note. But with that, 4th of July is Saturday. Yeah, Saturday.
Yes.
Saturday.
Yes.
So it's a different, complete 4th of July than we've had ever. And a lot of people, fireworks are being canceled. So we were wondering, is anybody going to miss the fireworks? Are you going to miss the fireworks, Kate?
Not really. I like doing the little fireworks with my kids. I think that's more fun. But it's kind of for me, once you've seen them, especially I've gotten a chance to see some really amazing ones, it's kind of like, But my enjoyment is watching my kids get excited. So I enjoy my kids watching them because it's exciting to them.
Firework is a firework, is what you're telling me, pretty much.
No, not... Well, it just...
There's only so much you can do with a firework.
Yeah.
Up, boom, there it is.
Yeah, I mean, especially now when they... Depending on where you go, they add light shows or they'll do different things. And, I mean, that's really cool. But my enjoyment now is watching them through my kids because my kids really love them.
Is anybody going to miss the fireworks this year? Anybody that's kind of bummed there won't be fireworks? Or are we sort of... Maybe we could ask that. Maybe that's a good question.
I think it maybe would be because it's a tradition. Maybe not necessarily watching the fireworks, but because that's just what generally a majority of people do.
That's a good...
That it might be more the tradition and something that's changing and there's no option.
Okay, so the question is, fireworks or no fireworks? Can you have 4th of July without fireworks? Or do you have to have fireworks for your 4th of July? So, we're with you, Sister Beverly, because we have the same thing happen in our neighborhood. Yes, we live in Glen Burnie, Randy, and that is the true statement.
Yes.
I don't know what is happening in Glen Burnie, but my goodness, it is like Glen Burnie fireworks ever.
Every night. So true.
Now that's true. Now Leanne Doolin is correct. I do like that.
Are they doing that? So no? They're not doing any?
I don't know. Morris, what's up, brother?
Oh, hello.
You're back. What is happening, man? Thanks for hopping back on again tonight.
I know.
So that's a question, Leanne. Do you know if they're doing are they doing the Capitol 4th? Because we do watch that with our kids. That's actually enjoyable to watch. So are they going to do it this year with no crowds?
That's what I was thinking, because then you at least can watch.
Oh, I don't know, Estella. That's a big ask. That could go wrong quickly. That could go really...
Oh, but home fireworks are so much fun.
True. True. But
as long as no one gets blown up.
Yes, but everybody that lives in Glen Burnie is feeling the same thing.
No,
it is
true.
Literally every night I feel like we're living with Francis Scott Key. It is just explosion after explosion.
Very much.
But see, Liz says she loves going to the big show but hasn't done it in a long time. If you went back though, I don't know if it feels the same. As kids though, it's different. But now Disney does a good job with fireworks. If you ever had a chance to go to Disney World, that's a good experience, but I don't know. It feels like a mixed bag.
But even with that, though, it's kind of like once.
Yeah. It's just Regina. It seems like everybody is having firework issues in their neighborhood. Regina says it's been happening since June 1st. That's actually about the, it's a repeat performance.
Oh, hi, Nicole. It's good to see you.
Hey, how you doing, Nicole?
Sister Vogler. Hello.
So,
welcome.
Yeah, this is, do sparklers and swim against the culture.
I agree, Leon.
Be edgy.
Yes.
Wow, that's tough.
I love sparklers.
Are sparklers edgy? Are we saying sparklers are edgy?
I don't know. I love sparklers.
We are sparklers. That's, according to, thank you, Joe. Joe has told us, according to Google, PBS will do fireworks this year. We don't know if it's live or, oh God, help us. I'm not even reading that, Vic. I'll let everybody else read that comment. I'll just skip over that one. I'll just skip right over that one. I'll let that one just get pushed up in the feed as it goes up.
Hi, Sir Angie.
Oh, thanks, Liz. I appreciate that. Yeah, thank you for that. Liz is saying it's only going to get worse.
Oh, great.
Thank you for that. I appreciate that.
It's okay, though. It keeps it interesting.
Except when it's like 1 a.m. and one goes off right near your house and you feel like you're literally about to duck for cover. Yes. So, anyways, but it's going to be a different 4th of July, but we do hope that you get a chance to have some semblance of a holiday and have some fun, even though it's different. Everything is different now.
But hopefully you're still getting together within something. Social distancing.
Friends and family. But anyways, we just kind of wanted to say that this, again, next weekend, we will not be on 4th of July weekend. Some of you probably be doing other things, going out of town, hopefully enjoying some nice good weather. So anyways, we're going to take next week off. And maybe we'll just put a loop of Shane's happy dance on a loop and just play that live as a replay of
Right Home. Was great, Shane.
Thank you, Shane, for making
that was a lot of fun.
This is funny. So, anyways, we're going to take a week off, and we've had a couple of sort of, we had 2 weeks ago. We actually had a really awesome time 2 weeks ago. God just sort of showed up and took over, and that was awesome. But last week our kids were on. And we had some time with them, and we had some last one. No, but we just want to hang out for a few minutes, have some good, some fun laughs. Because really, honestly, one of the big things we try to do when we come on here is connect and engage with you guys. Have some fun, laugh a little bit, because I know right now we all could use more laughter in our life. But if God decides to... Oh, thank you, Shane. Wright not at home. but we honestly would just want to come on and if it turns into something where it gets serious, great. If it's turned into something where it's just a bunch of fun goofiness and we talk about Shane and his happy dance, that's great too. But we were honestly just trying to be a part of this, and ultimately you and doing this with you is what has made us want to do this for the last... Yeah.
Well, we want to interact with you.
3 months? Has it been 3 months?
No. Has it?
April, May, June.
Really?
3 months of Right at Home. I don't know. We've lasted longer than some other ventures of mine have lasted. So, anyways.
It hasn't felt that long.
It hasn't been felt that long, but in other ways, it feels like an eternity.
Not with him, but no. Yes, just...
No. But anyways, so... I don't know. It seems like it's getting really heavy. So let's have some fun tonight, and let's see. Let's laugh a little bit. Let's have some fun, and let's see where the road takes. Let's get the people out, Kate. Let's get them out on the open road and just open them up and just see what happens. Let's see if we can get some limbered fingers and start seeing if we can get some good interaction going. You look at me with doubt. I'm struggling here. Why are you looking at me like that? You're the voice of the people. So what do the people say, Kate? What are the people saying?
I don't think anything at the moment.
Okay. All right. So I have a question for you, Kate. I got a good one for you. And you can answer for me and I'll answer for you, but they can all answer for themselves. I think this is a good one. I've been waiting for that. I had this one in the holster. I've had this in the holster for a while. I'm ready to pull it out and fire away.
Okay.
Are you ready? Okay, here you go. If you came with a warning label, what would it be?
If I did?
Yeah, if you came with a warning label, what would it say? But to be kind, I'm going to let you answer what my warning label would be. And then just because I'm that kind of guy, I'm going to answer what your warning label would be. And then, people, I'd like to hear what your warning label would be. If you came with a warning label... For you, what would the warning label say? So you can answer for me. So what would my warning label say? And notice I am easily offended and hurt. So make it good.
Okay. Social distancing is necessary. I spray.
Are you saying I'm a spitter when I talk?
Oh, I am. Yes. Especially now, during.
What does now
social
mean?
Social distancing is very important. So that's what I would say.
Oh wow, John Lombardo says warning, wide load. I do like that, Leanne. Caution. So mine for you would be. If grumpy, check for low food or low sleep. Yeah, that's it. What I mean, I'm telling you. I tell you. See. Well, that's this does sound dangerous, Liz, but I'm venturing out. I am just venturing out. So mine would be keep back 6 feet. He's a spitter.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
And then mine for you would be if grumpy, check for low food and low sleep.
Sadly, yeah.
Because you get a little hangry. There's some hangry. Even your kids are like, Mom, have you eaten?
Thank you.
Anyways, yes, Morris, I know. But I just feel like I'm venturing out. This is good. Don't stick your fingers into the cage. Somehow, Vic, I actually feel like that is a true warning label for you. So what would your warning label B for yourself? So let's just make it easier.
Yeah, what would yours be?
Yeah, Liz, what would yours be? I won't ask you what yours would be for Curtis. I won't do that to you. But if you had a warning label, what would your warning label be for yourself? So we've had so far, well, that's actually Kathy has a good one. And it's true, sarcasm spot in the area. Kathy, I have to say, you are correct on that. So what would be a good warning label? Yes, see, your sister says she does get hangry. This is something. But it's okay, Kate. People don't realize. Yes, do y'all know? Can we just say it?
Go right ahead.
Do y'all know she can out-eat me?
Yes,
True story. We were in New York.
You're going to actually tell that story?
Oh, yes, Kate. People need to know. The voice of the people needs to be told.
Great.
We were in New York. We were with some friends in New York. We went to a pizza place in Times Square. We ordered two large pizzas. My wife, a whole large pizza by herself. Now, granted, it was a thin crust, right? It was thin crust.
It was.
But a whole large pizza, boom, took it out. Boom, one sitting. Is it a true story, Kate? True story.
It is.
Yes. Yes.
But yeah, I do like food.
Shane Bailey said, if I'm here, you broke something. See, Chris doesn't doubt you eat that. Oh, Liz says, if I'm reading a book, please don't talk to me. Okay.
Yeah, Liz, that's about, yeah.
Jeff Smith, I am struggling believing that.
Place full of love.
John Lombardo says, if found, do not feed. He won't leave. May combust under pressure. Wow. Your sister is just totally throwing
you
under the bus. She's throwing you under the bus, Kate.
Okay, this coming from a girl that eats one meal a day.
Hello, Kim.
Yes, Laurie. Yes. Oh, hi, Kim. It's good to see you.
So, this is may combust under pressure. We won't even ask the fullness. Actually, Estella, I should ask David if that is if that's true. If that's a true. So, anyways, but I thought we would want to share this with everybody, because that was something I thought about. Like, if I had a warning label, because I am a spitter. I am. I'll admit, I'm a sprayer.
It's okay.
I'm a sprayer. Yes. I'm working on it. Mm-hmm. I'm working on
it. But right now, in this current situation, that's not a good thing.
Yes, not good. I would not do well.
No.
I'd.
We are thankful for something.
Yes. Oh, it's terrible, Chris. Terrible. We're gonna need marriage counseling when this is over. Chris says his wife needs help reaching high places.
That's terrible.
I might have like opened up the floodgates here. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, folks. Mm-hmm. Like, we were told this could be. Liz said it was going to be rough, and Morris said it was going to be rough, and looks like this could get.
Aw, Trish, that's perfect for
this
you.
This is true.
That is perfect true. For you.
Ivy, now this is something a lot of people should probably put.
I was wondering why you said it so many times. I'm like, is he stuttering? A lot of people.
Is it true?
I'm like, and then I realized.
I was scratching. A lot of people
you
need
are
that
lying.
I'm not.
That's not good.
Kate.
That's not good.
I speak the truth. I'm a.
You
I'm
just
a,
pointed at me.
Kate, I wasn't. I had a cramp in my finger. This is true. That's true.
But true. John, it's fun. It's fun eating pizza. It's just
true.
So good.
Until it's all over and then you're like, why? Why? Why did I do this?
It's still fun.
So, anyways, Jeff Smith is really throwing a lot of heart emojis out there. I'm kind of nervous.
Okay, I want to hear Deborah.
Yes,
Smith.
Is this?
I want to hear.
We need verification. Wow, Michelle came strong with the actual caution emoji.
Oh, Michelle, I love that.
I'm impressed, Michelle. You came strong with a caution emoji. I like that.
Oh, that's awesome, Randy. Can't process any new information after 9 p.m.
This is true.
Is that a marital thing?
What's that?
Because usually women like to talk. So then, like, after 9, I can see the guy, like, being done. Like, you, I could see, because, you know, I'm such a chatterbox.
Yeah. My wife is a morning chatter, and I am not. And so she likes to hit the ground running, and I'm sort of like trying to get the brain working. So,
but we're a good team.
But you know what, Kate? It's not boring.
What's that?
Life's not boring with us in this house. It's not boring. So that's a question. Finish this statement. This is a good question. Okay. Life would be boring without. Life would be boring without. So someone answer that question. Life would be boring without what?
Kids. My children.
Yeah. It'd also be a lot quieter, though. Angelo, what's up? 2 weeks in a row.
Yay.
Angelo Thomas
Welcome
coming
back.
Strong with some comments. What's
yes.
up, Angelo?
Oh, I love that. That's awesome.
So finish this statement.
Yes.
Life would be boring without sharks. That really goes back up to the previous comment by Kathy. Sarcasm
awesome.
Warning. Things.
No, like
sharks.
Yeah. We know she loves sharks.
Jesus. Now Lori's just going deep on us, man. We're all just Lori's just gonna trump
family
us.
Family is true.
Hello, Len!
Hey, welcome back.
What is
Thank
up?
Thank you.
Katie and Sadie Bickley.
Oh,
chocolate.
Hi, Bailey. Yes.
Okay. Whoa, time out. Is she saying that or you just typed that in?
I cannot see her saying that.
The love machine. And I'm going to work on the bottom. Sorry, it's going bad. I'm telling you, you can't throw lyrics out to a song and not expect me to start singing them. It's going to happen.
Oh,
this
is trying to derail.
If you start, it's going to derail quick. If they start throwing old school music out there, lyrics, Kate, it's off. I'm done. So... this is true, Leah. Netflix. So life would be boring without
desserts.
Yeah.
Kathy, we know that you love sharks. Mm. Absolutely.
Netflix.
I believe that. She would have a hole in her life without them.
Your sister said life would be boring without color. Motorcycles. James is our resident.
Oh, hi, Howie.
Motorhead. Every comment James Keller ever gives on Ride at Home somehow is going to work its way back to motorcycles. We could be talking about what's the next great invention, and it's going to go back. oh, my goodness. See, Jeff Smith's going to mess with me now. No, my goodness. I'm trying to resist. I'm trying to resist because I feel like it's once it starts.
I know. We'll have to hold you back.
What's love got to do? Got to do with it? I just can't. I can't. I'm trying. Jesus be a fence, Kate. I'm telling you. People just don't know. If it starts happening, it's going downhill.
Oh, man.
I'm trying to resist.
Okay.
But you know I can't resist when it comes to the old school lyrics. It just comes out. Chris, is that your attention to... Is that your...
I know.
Chris is trying to redeem himself. Now he's saying his wife because he called his wife short before. Now he's redeeming himself.
Oh.
My 89-year-old mother. Anyway. Aww. Yes. So life... So the question we're throwing out there right now, we're having a little fun, is life would be boring without, and you fill in the blank.
Yeah.
What is the next great invention? I don't know, Shane. That's Bailey.
No, that's Bailey.
I saw Bailey, and I was just, Shane's been on my mind since the very beginning. Nick Jolin, don't do it, man. Don't do it. Oh, no. It's going derail. Okay.
Joel Wright, there's a limit.
Oh, please. It's there, Kate. It's there.
It's going to have to stay there. Not that one.
Jeff Smith.
There's a limit.
It was Jeff Smith's fault, though.
I know.
Though.
We're going to get a phone call. I know.
Can I turn my phone off and sing that? I don't see the bishop yet. Is he on here yet? I can sing it. Morris Bond's fishing? Really?
That's, oh, wow. I would never.
I think you're the first fishing guy coming on here. What would be
Thank
boring
you,
without
Laurie.
Fishing?
Thank you, Laurie.
Oh, man. I do like My Girl. That's a good song.
You can sing that one.
But I like the other one. That's better.
We got a limit.
It's Jeff Smith's fault. He's the one that did it.
I know. You're going to get us fired.
So, talking about My Girl. My Girl. Ooh. We could have a whole singing episode. Just old school songs. And then that would be the last time I'd be online because I'd probably get a call the next day. And I'll just have to, Jeff, I'll come live with you and we can sing together all the time. So we were actually having this. Oh, see, he's doing it, folks. It's Jeff Smith. He's the antagonist of this evening's whole day. It's you, Jeff. It's you. Jesus help us. Your wife needs to lay hands on you right now in Jesus' name. You're just trying to mess with me. I'm telling you. Oh, God. Just my imagination.
Man, you guys.
Gay, I'm telling you, they're messing with my head. I do like that one. Just my imagination.
Go ahead.
Running away with me. Mm-hmm. It was just my imagination running away with me. It's Deborah. Do we believe that?
No. No. There's no way.
I'm not buying. I need verification for that. I'm going to need some kind of verification.
She's going to have to text me.
Yeah, I'm going to need some verification for that. Mm-hmm. So, that was something. Life would be boring. So the question was life would be boring. So, we're having fun. This is fun.
I know.
Next one. I had all these come to me today. Based on your wardrobe, what would be your favorite color?
Black.
Wow.
I love black. I love the color black.
Black. Mm-hmm. Based off your wardrobe, your color would be black.
I have black on right now except denim.
I used to say it would probably be blue, but probably now I've skewed more to black.
Yeah.
Probably.
Although you're wearing blue right now.
I know. Red. Regina's going to go with red. This is cute. Oh. Mustard.
Ooh.
Wow.
Interesting.
Black.
And this is what you all wear?
Yes.
A lot?
Oh, Jake Jolin, don't do it, man. Everybody, look, black is coming strong.
Black is just classic. It's just classic.
Latrice says black. Christine color is black. Michelle doing black.
Yeah, it's a classic color.
Sister black. Cheryl from our New Mexico friend is black. Black,
really?
Everybody. Wow, I'm shocked.
This is amazing. Aw, Sister Vogler purple.
Sister Vogler's giving us some color. Oh, we need
Christine.
Color in our love because everyone's coming with black.
Neon pink.
Rose, are you serious? This is
wow.
true. Neon pink. I would have never guessed this question would have gone black. No, Brant. Take it off. Delete it. Delete it. Delete it. Delete it. Put them down. Put them down. Put them down. Wow.
I'm loving it, you guys. This is awesome.
Wow. Everybody's coming strong with Mackenzie. Morris has got black. Kathy's got black.
I know.
Sheila's black. Chris. Yes. Wow. I wouldn't. Baby poo mustard. I can't even read the comments out loud anymore. They're getting. Okay. See? James Keller, everything has to go back to a motorcycle. See, this is true. Now, Leon actually hit something.
Very
this is true.
True.
That is that very true. It does hide well. Mm-hmm. Norlene says turquoise. Scarlet and gray. Okay, Ohio State does not count. Nope. No Ohio State. You can't go with the Ohio State colors. black. I would have never imagined black was such a strong wardrobe color. I mean, I know people wear a lot of black, but I wouldn't imagine based off people's wardrobe that would be the.
Yeah, it's a classic.
Was it classic or just hides well?
Both. It does.
So everybody sort of looks good in black, is what you're saying?
Yeah, because the chances of if you do get something on you, you can't see it. I mean, if you spill something on you it's just easy. If you sit down on something, it hides everything well.
Black. So the question we asked, which I was amazed at, was, it's slimming. Say Leon says it's slimming. Mm-hmm. Holly's just going all the colors of the world. She's just a rainbow of love.
Actually, that is true. Now, Holly, I gotta say, she rotates her colors.
I'm gonna have to skip over Jeff Smith's comments for a while now because he's just killing me here with the songs. These are not, you're taking me. Pentecostal black with a white shirt. I'm actually surprised in the answer to that black is the strong color. But
Grandma Francis says blue.
Grandma Francis is blue. Bringing color into our life tonight. So that actually is amazing. So the question was, based on your wardrobe, it looks like black just destroyed it. And you know what's funny? Last week, we did this kind of, Enoch, what's up, Enoch? Welcome back. We missed you in a couple weeks. Haven't seen you, our fellow Georgian. Well, it's not our fellow Georgian. We're not from Georgia. But our fellow Marylander that's in Georgia. That's a good song, by the way, Georgia.
Okay. Focus.
No, I'm telling you, songs are. It's Jeff Smith's fault, Kate. Georgia is a great song. Little Ray Charles, can't go wrong. But now I lost my train of thought. What was I going to say? What were we just talking about? I've lost it. Wow. This is rough.
We were talking about the colors.
Colors of the world, colors of love.
But you jump all over and then.
I was. It's the song stuff that's messing with me big time. What was I going to say? Oh, Lord. Man, this is rough. This is bad. So,
okay.
How's your day going so far? How's it going? It's good to see you. How's it been? This is good. How's things happening in your world? What was I talking about?
You were talking about the colors.
See, I think we're just going to have a song lyric night. It's the voice of the people. We got When a Man Loves a Woman.
Okay, well, if that happens.
Georgia on my mind.
I love you guys. And I'm going to exit.
Oh, no, Kate, because I'm going to get you singing by the end of the night.
No.
Come on. I'm going to get you singing by the end of the night.
Singing?
Oh, yeah, Kate. I'm going to bring it out. I'm going to pull it out of you. What was I saying? I said something earlier.
It's okay. We can just kind of let it go. I don't know.
Let it go. Another good song. Classic Disney princess song. Let it go. Everything goes back to a song, Kate. It's all going back. I don't know what's happened. We have just derailed. It's the music. They say the rhythm's going to get you. The rhythm has got us tonight.
Hi, Linda. It's good to see you.
Yes. Hello. Yes! Sing-along!
No, baby,
this would be great.
Helping.
A sing-along. No. A right-at-home sing-along. Hello, Linda! Look at the people, Kate. Look at how many we're getting. It's blowing up right there. 4 clicks on that one comment. Sitting on the dock. Vic Jolin's song knowledge goes deep. I'm impressed, man. This is awesome.
Thank you, Laurie. Someone is helping me.
What is? You don't know if she's saying no, like no, a bad idea.
No,
right.
I know Laurie. She's in agreement with
me. No, she could be saying no, this is a great idea. I was saying hi to Enoch, and then Enoch, I said hello to Enoch, and I just lost my train of thought. I don't know what I was saying before Enoch.
Hi, Katie.
I don't know
Love
what
you.
I was
I
saying.
I miss you.
What was I saying before Enoch?
Okay, I think it's safe to say it's obviously gone.
I think it's the singing that's... Look, we got 5 clicks. It's 5-1. The singing's beating the...
Five. Okay. Do I need to...
Yeah, take it over, okay? Because it's all... The music's in my brain now. It's all downhill from here. Oh, the color. So based on your wardrobe, that black is,
is the
favorite color. That was... And I know what I was going to say. That's what it was. See, it came back to
me. Okay, but stay... But make... Stay that.
We did a kind of a this or that last week. And those of you that weren't on, we had a debate on, like, we had some, like, bacon. What was it? Bacon or sausage?
Yeah.
Like, bacon destroyed sausage. We had mountains or ocean. Ocean destroyed mountains. I was actually shocked at some of that. And so the black thing is amazed. Well, I was surprised.
No, I could have eaten. No, black is just a classic. For so many reasons.
Sister Shirl speaking truth.
Yes.
I need a vacation.
Yes.
I need a vacation. So, I got another question. Because this actually, we try now, like,
seriously?
If we actually think of something, we kind of write it down and remember. And this was something that came up because my wife was actually saying this to our kids. When you were a kid, what was the first thing when you could remember? What was the first thing you really wanted to be when you were a kid? What was the first, like, when you were a kid, what did you want to be?
I wanted to be a veterinarian because I just loved animals so much.
And so you married me. What does that say, Kate? Wow.
No, that is very true, though. I do love animals.
Wow.
I had pretty much every kind of animal.
And why don't you think the veterinary thing was something you wanted to go into? What?
Seriously?
Yeah, what was something like, what was, could you think you could have done it or do you think that would have been?
No, I can't put animals down. I think we had several instances where we had to do that and that was just too painful and hard. And I just have a compassion for animals. Hmm. I don't think I could have done that.
Wow.
And then watching them in pain and that's hard.
Wow. So. Chris Height, I would have never guessed a Major League Baseball player. We got a pediatrician and a mathematician. Wow. Victoria, we got a lot of nurses. Did you know your mom wanted to be a nurse?
No.
Wow.
Mom, I learned something new.
John Lombardo said Evel Knievel. I love that. More spawns in the army. That's cool.
Wow.
Actually, I wanted to be, my first real thing as a kid that I remember wanting to be, and I was young, was a Blue Angel pilot. But then when I hit my growth spurt, that dream just went straight out the window. Because I am not cramming myself into a small plane.
Aw, guys, this is amazing.
Paul Mislanic, what's up?
Oh, hello. So Linda, you want to be a teacher?
See, Leon, actually, I can buy that, Leon. It's true. You would have made a good lawyer. So we saw we got a lot of doctors, lawyers, nurture.
Leon, you would have made a good one. But you are just too sweet.
Yes. That is awesome. That is awesome.
Which one?
Maddie White says, when I was 5 years old, I wanted to be a bodybuilder. That is awesome. That was so good.
Really, Kim? That's awesome. See, we should have done it. We would have had a practice.
Professional cheerleader for the Browns. I'm hoping that's still his wife texting
Anita Lindsay.
I'm hoping that's still. See, actually, Vic, that's really.
Professional cheerleader for the Browns.
And I'm hoping that's his wife saying that.
She said it was her.
Okay, so I'm going to go with that. Paul Mislanic going strong with a Navy SEAL.
That's awesome.
These are cool. Joe Bickley with a truck driver. Wow.
Wow.
Actually, that's pretty amazing, Tasha. When you were a kid, that's really. You wanted to live in Africa and have a children's home.
Oh, that's
James
amazing.
Keller wanted to be an architect. Is that an architect of houses or an architect of motorcycles, James? I'm surprised you didn't want to be a motorcycle designer.
That's amazing.
Oh, that's hilarious. Manny White is killing me with
this. Okay, Joe, is that really true? A truck driver?
That's true. Latrice,
Ford.
You win. She wins. That's so true.
That is very true.
My wife is a master detective. You should see her when it goes into interrogation time with her kids. Who spilled this? I don't know. Okay. Is it true? Don't sit there.
I'm not like that.
You're not like every mom is like that. No, it's a universal mom thing. Don't sit there and act like every mom knows it. Every mom knows how to take it out. Moms know how to pull it out.
I have a child sitting right here.
Yes, our daughter's sitting here shaking her head.
Nodding, yes.
Yes. So Lynn's Lister said a marine biologist.
Really? Oh, wow. James said, see, I was trying to leave the motorcycle out and you brought it back.
Sister Vogel said she wanted to be a flight attendant.
Oh, Karen, it is true. Okay. I would not have thought
wow.
that. Wow. You love driving.
Wow.
Joe really wanted to be that.
That's interesting. Wow.
Jeff Smith, yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That's funny. But I'm telling you, the mom thing, Latrice is
true. That is
every mom...
I'll
see, every mom has to be a good detective. Is it true?
No.
Moms have it built in you.
Yeah.
Moms are... Yeah. See, Karen Bickley would have been a master detective. Bailey, can you please verify? Your mom would have made the best... We wouldn't have a crime problem if Karen Bickley was a detective. Telling you, she can take him out. Karen Bickley can find him. She will find him.
Sister Cheryl. Yes. Yes.
Why? Why? Why would you do that to me?
I like
Sister
you.
Cheryl, why?
You're my friend.
Why? Why? You can go to New Mexico with her and I'm stuck
love
here.
To. I've never been.
Why? Wow. That's just... Mackenzie Bailey said a ballerina.
Aw, that's wonderful, Mackenzie.
That would be cool. Until, I don't know, the toe thing would be difficult.
Yeah.
That would be rough. But I'm not leaving this mom detective thing alone. This has got to be established. Mom detectives are legit. It's true.
Yeah, it is true.
Mom detectives are true. Yes. Oh, yes. Kid.
Oh, good, Joe. Thank you.
I have permission, Joe?
Yes, Joe said. Tell the story about the family.
I need verification from Karen. I can't do that to her, Joe.
Oh, that would be
this cool. is on live...
Oh, guys,
this is
so much
on
fun.
Live television.
Oh, this is a great story.
This is a great story. Oh, maybe
Karen,
the best story of all
please.
Time.
We'll keep the names out of it.
Yes, we won't tell the names.
No, we won't say the names.
But can we get verification, Joe, that from your wife that this story could be told?
Yes, Joe.
This may be the greatest story of ever time. This is a true story verified by multiple witnesses.
This is how amazing Karen Bickley
is. Karen Bickley went to the top of my list with this story. To tell you what, if you want a job done, Karen's your woman. She is here. She gives verification. Oh, Karen. This is the best. Okay. Y'all got to hear the story. Karen Bickley, if you ever have a problem, this is you call her. She can get it done. They had some renters in their house. Their basement had a situation in her house. And so they had some renters. And the renters kept leaving the ceiling fan on when they weren't home and burning electricity. And they were asked kindly several times, please don't leave the ceiling fans on. Well, they didn't hear clearly the instructions given. So Karen, Detective Karen, decided one day when they were gone and they weren't home, she went down into the area and unscrewed the blades off of the ceiling fan and left them with no blades on the fan, just the little part that spins, and no blades. So when they came back home, they had no blades in the ceiling fan. She had gone down there and unscrewed the blades off the ceiling fan and left them with no fan. You cannot get better than that. When that story was told to me years ago, Karen went to the top of my list. If you ever have
That's
a problem.
Amazing. I would never, I wouldn't think to take the blades off. Like
Karen, she took the blades off. You don't turn the ceiling fans off. When you're gone, she snuck down and took off the blades off the fan and left them with no fan. Like, that was just the best
Karen,
idea.
We love you
because
so
the,
much.
The awesome part about that story. Awesome part about that story is if you would have taken the fan down, I don't think that would have had the impact as leaving the fan intact with no blades. That is awesome. Like you can't, that's just so good. Like that's like getting your point across. That's a mic drop moment. That's like a, drop the mic moment because you just can't beat that. If you take the fan and leave a big hole, that's just sort of like
Karen,
going to the extreme.
Love you.
But the blade thing was just the best.
That was great.
The best. Just awesome. Yeah. I mean,
don't mess
with
Karen Bickley.
Yes, I mean, oh,
yes,
that's another truth.
That's right.
That's another one. Uh-huh. This is the Bickley family. This is Bickley family time, okay? It's the Bickley family. Bailey's on here. Bailey, I'm sorry. This is your dad threw it out there. Bailey was having some growing pain moments in her teenage years and decided she wanted to step out there a little bit. And I think she slammed the door.
Yeah.
Or shut the door.
No.
Slammed the door.
Okay,
and so
Bailey.
To
change
that little tactic of slamming the door, Karen and I think she had the help of Joe on this one. They took the door off. Took the door right off. No door on going to her bedroom. So, see? Karen, look at that. People got to learn their lessons. I'm telling you, that is the best. You can't beat that.
Oh,
that is awesome.
There's some great stories.
So, Trish Bailey, like Lois Lane.
Actually, I could see that for you, Trish.
Secretary reporter like Lois Lane.
That would be awesome.
That's hilarious. So the question we had was, what was the first thing you wanted to be as a child when you grew up?
Yeah.
And we kind of it just kind of got derailed there by the whole fan story and the mom detective thing. But,
yeah.
Yes.
Aww.
Anyways, but this was a funny one. But we had the debate. Moms make great detectives. They really do.
Mm-hmm.
Tours and fans are overrated. Anyways, apparently, Leon, if you're in the Bickley household, that's a true statement. Who needs tours and fans? So I had one more good one.
Okay.
I have one more good one.
Right.
This one may take a little thinking, folks, because we're going to do this and we're going to play one more game and then we'll be off tonight because this was a good one. If blank, because Olympics got canceled this year because of the coronavirus. So here's a good question. In honor of the Olympics, which would be going on right within the next couple weeks. Oh, wow. It just got serious here. Wow.
Ow.
Ouch. John Lombardo says his dad shut the window in his hands when he caught him sneaking back in the house was when he was a teen. So, John, based off that, did you ever sneak out again? I'm guessing that cured the sneaking out of the soup's sneaking out. And so, anyways, so because the Olympics were canceled or postponed, so the question is, if blank was an Olympic sport, You have to answer this question for yourself. So I gotta preface this.
Okay.
So Phil, answer this question for yourself.
All right.
So here's the question, folks. If blank was an Olympic event, I would totally have a gold medal. So if blank was an Olympic event, I would totally have a gold medal. So Kate, for you, if blank was an Olympic event, I would totally have a gold medal. What would that be?
Cleaning. I don't even have to think about that one.
Where's the ding, ding, ding button? I have a ding, ding, ding. Where's this button? No, that's the wrong one. Nope. I don't even know where the button is.
What are you doing?
No, I need the clapping button. Because that's a true statement. If cleaning was an Olympic event, you would so have a Olympic medal. Christine Keller, such a mom thing, so true. Cleaning up children's toys,
yes.
So true.
Amy, yes.
Rose is going with karaoke.
Karaoke.
That's awesome, Rose. I had no idea.
Kathy, I could see that.
Wow.
Oh,
jump rope, Beverly Randy. Finch, you go, girl.
That's awesome. All right.
Oh, this is good, folks. Shopping, sleeping.
Cow patty tossing.
Wow.
Shopping.
Sheila says cleaning also. Anita Lindsay is saying writing. We got a lot of sleeping.
Yes.
A lot of sleeping. So the question we had, folks, if you just jumped on and you know what's going on, if blank was an Olympic event, I would totally have a gold medal. baking or eating pizza?
I do.
Wow. Hey, Heidi, how are you doing?
Hi, Heidi.
What's up? Teaching. Nerea!
Hey, the doctor. Just, like, come out.
The doctor has spoken. Nerea.
Okay, Latrice, I might need you to come to my house. True. That is one thing I can't stand doing is folding laundry.
Wow.
Ugh, I don't like that. Although, it may not be because you like it. It's just
Tamika says sleeping. Leanne typing.
Sleeping. Oh.
Wow. Sister Vogler is just trying to touch. She's just trying to trump. She's
no.
Serving sister, people?
Absolutely.
Lance Lister says procrastinating. Really? Is that? I would never guess. Lynn, are you a procrastinator? I would have never guessed that.
Oh, Sister Cheryl says ignoring chores.
Yeah, it's like Sister Cheryl and Lynn may have a little competition there.
And James with motorcycling.
Shooting a rifle. Ivy! Really?
Oh, Ivy!
Really?
That's cool.
That's hilarious.
That's awesome.
Shooting a rifle.
But
Ivy.
You know what? I could see Ivy doing that.
Jeff singing old songs.
Okay.
Optimism.
So, Jeff Smith, is that you or your wife?
Seems like that's Deborah coming strong with the old song collection.
That's what I think.
Being wired without drinking coffee.
Actually, that is true. Victoria, yes.
See, that's true, Lynn. I kind of live by that a lot of times. I'm trying to break
great.
It.
That's great. Awesome. That's awesome.
Ivy, that's awesome.
That's really cool. That's awesome.
Floating in a pool like a log.
That is awesome.
So yours would be cleaning. That's good.
Yes.
Charmaine!
Oh, hello.
She goes with coffee.
Coffee
drinking. Kate, you would have you could give him a run on that gold medal there for that. Mm-hmm. Definitely. Although, I do know somebody that probably could beat anyone in that. Mm-hmm. That is my friend Scott Shelton, because he doesn't drink coffee by the cups. He drinks it by the pots.
Yeah.
Literally.
Yeah.
By the pots. He doesn't say, how many cups of coffee you had today? It's usually, how many pots of coffee have you had today?
Okay, so Jeff Smith, have to be honest, it's been on me. Who?
That's Deborah.
Really?
That's hilarious. She's just going incognito using her husband as cover. Oh,
that's
my
awesome.
Goodness. So what would mine be? If Olympic, what would mine be? Certainly not cleaning. I would not have a gold medal in cleaning. I wouldn't even make it to the Olympics if cleaning was involved. I wouldn't even make it to the... I wouldn't even have got out of the amateur ranks. I wouldn't even have made the JV team in cleaning. I'm way cleaning. Paul Miss Lanik is going with turning light bulbs. Only electrician could say that, Paul. Spoken like an electrician. Pothead. anyways... mine would be, I should say it. I could say it, but it may come out wrong.
Then you shouldn't.
Well, you know me, Kate.
If
I stop
that's
with saying,
what you shouldn't.
Then you, when you say that, now I have to say it.
No, you don't.
Oh, yes, I do. You know, I'm, you know me. If blank was an Olympic event, I would totally have a gold medal. I would have to go with fake preaching.
Oh, yeah. That's not a good thing.
It's not a good thing, but we play a game when we're sometimes on a road trip. Some people play sing-along. We play a game where my wife or my family will throw out a word or point to a billboard, and I have to come up with I have to preach on that subject. One of the hardest ones was a funeral home. That was very difficult.
Yeah.
But I brought it home, Kate.
You did, but I brought
it home.
I would have admitted that.
I brought it home. Morris says I'm being awesome. So that would be it. So I'm not going to venture out. I can literally take a word, almost any word.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let's not do it though.
You can just
say it.
I can make it. It's just. I'm not saying it's a good thing.
No. Oh no, it's not a good thing.
It's just a lot of years Mm-hmm. It's a lot of years of stuff built in me. Mm-hmm. So one day I'd like to just, we could have a hat, put a bunch of words in a hat. We could pull out a word, like, and I would, see, Bailey says to play the game next week. It's like, how about we could have a bucket with random, and I have to pick out three random words, and I have to preach on that subject just like that.
Okay.
And then I'll have to repent when it's all over, because it's not Jesus whatsoever. It's just pure, pure goofiness, I think. But that would be mine. Do you believe that? Could I get a gold medal in that? Mm-hmm. I'm not saying it's a good thing.
All right, Estella's was making up random songs to annoy my kids and random dancing to catch them off guard. Oh my goodness, you guys, with the songs.
Apparently, Kate.
Next Timothy Ray at home.
Okay, thank you, Vic. I preach that. I thank Vic. Ha, ha, ha. I have not worn a shiny suit in a while because we have been wearing suits. So, ha, ha. I like my shiny suits. They give me a sheen.
Mm-hmm. No, I'm agreeing. You look very nice in them.
I didn't feel the sincerity coming
from
that.
Well, first of all, if I didn't think so, you wouldn't have worn them. So.
Wow. Wow, Kate. That hit deep.
I would have said very kindly that, no, I love your shiny
that
suits.
That struck me deep.
Why?
I don't know.
We're
just
a team, right? You help me, I help you.
Okay. I'm scared to answer that.
Okay,
last one. And we're going to play this. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to play a quick game real quick. I came across this and I thought it'd be fun to make into a game. And this is actually going to be, this is going to be something challenging.
Trish, that is true. Very true.
Yeah, but I will say Naria, she's on here tonight. She actually put it to the biggest test of all time, ever. Naria, I still love you for it. You know we're tight.
You should love her for that.
It was an awesome experience, but I almost, literally, almost passed out when she asked me to do that.
But it was fine. It worked.
It was.
It was awesome.
We told that story a couple months ago. But that was it. But so here, how are we going to play this game? Mm-hmm. I'm going to give you a line from an old hymn. The first person who can put it in the comment box, because we're going to go by people, by which comment hits first. That's the person who will get the point. And basically, the way it's going to work is I'm going to read you a line from a hymn, but you have to get the name of the hymn, the title of the hymn exactly. You can't just give me like something random. You actually have to give me the exact name of the hymn. For example, I'll give you an easy one. Don't answer this one. I'll just give you an example. I would say, I once was lost, but now I'm found. Comes from what song? I once was lost, but now I'm found?
Amazing Grace.
Amazing Grace. Say it like you know.
Well, I wasn't sure you were asking.
So it'd be Amazing Grace.
I'm not good at this.
It would be Amazing Grace. So that's the idea. I will say a line to a song. I'm not going to sing it because singing gives it away. So let's see who can name that song that quickly. And for those of you that would like to Google it, hopefully someone will beat you to it before you can Google it. So you know we know that our Google people won't win. So here's the question. Ready? Okay, so we start with Amazing Grace. That was easy. So next one. First one. Ready? Here we go. First person put in the comment box. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. That's pretty easy. First one. First one to put in the comment box. You got to have the exact name of the song. It's got to have the title. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. This is like anticipation. Here we go. Drum roll. Whose name? Who's going to pop up first?
She's not even with him.
Hold on. I got to see. Oh, boom. Michelle Doolin came strong. She just beat out Kim McGurk with How Great Thou Art. Michelle Doolin, 1 point. All of it.
Debbie.
You gotta be faster. I don't know. It could be internet connection.
You guys are awesome.
Could be internet connection, folks.
But
could
we
be.
We have to go by the first.
We gotta go by the first one, Michelle Doolin.
You guys are awesome.
All right, next one.
Jason, how did you know I had Google ready to go?
All right, ready?
Here you go. You guys are awesome.
Next
Hi,
one.
Rita.
Here you go. Ready? First one to comment. I don't know if your internet connection, your Wi-Fi. I don't know. I know it's not fair because I don't know how the connections are. We're just going to roll
awesome,
with it.
Awesome, you guys.
Sing choirs of angels. Sing in exaltation. Sing choirs of angels. Sing in exaltation. You got to have the name of the song with the correct spelling and all the correct pronunciations. Sing choirs of angels. Sing in exaltation. Let's see who can get this. Okay, well, limber them up. Come on, limber those old thumbs up. Come on. Hark the Herald. Yes! But that's not it.
Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Aw, oh, hi, Aunt Pam. Welcome back.
Oh. No. Not yet.
It is. It's Hark the Herald, isn't it?
I don't have that.
What is it?
Everybody, no, it's a Christmas song. Yes, thank you. Oh, is anybody? Let me see if I got. This is what.
Oh, come on, Tyra, you can do it.
Quick, Kathy, that was close, but you didn't get the pronex.
Oh, come on, you.
You guys are spelling out the OH, but technically the OH. Yes, Sister Cheryl got it. She got it correct. Because that's the. I say it's got to be correctly spelled. She got it. It's actually O, the letter O. Come all ye faithful. It's not OH. I'm trying to be technical here, Kate. I'm trying to be fair to the people. Sister Cheryl, you got it. Leanne Doolin came back strong with it. It's technically the letter O.
Come on, Google.
Who said that? So it's technically O, come all ye faithful. Very good. Okay, this is a tricky one. I'm sure this might require someone to go on Google. Let's see if someone knows it. That flows by the throne of God. There's the lyrics, right? That flows, I'm going to get it again. That flows by the throne of God. That flows by the throne of God. There's the lyric. That flows by the throne of God. It's a hymn. It's an old hymn.
Really,
it's a tough one.
That's a hard
but someone may have to someone's gonna have to dig deep, or they just gonna be fast on Google. That flows by the throne of God. That's the one. Flows by the throne of God. Nope.
And no, I still
nope, that's
I
what Kate
that
said.
That
that's wasn't
what I
it.
Thought.
This is a tough one. It's a tough one. Nope. Boom.
Yes.
Got it.
Yes.
Gather at the River, Leanne Doolin.
Leanne Doolin.
Technically, it's Shall We Gather at the River. So, Trish, actually, I'm going to have to give... Jen, Maddie,
Jen,
what's up?
Hey!
Hello!
Hello!
So, technically, Trisha technically got it correct because it's Shall We Gather at the River. I'm sorry, Sister Doolin. I have to go with the technical one. Shall We Gather at the River? A lot of people thought it was the blood one because the blood
it
is...
It does. It sounds
that flows right. from Calvary.
Mm-hmm.
But this is that flows by... By the throne of God.
God.
Okay, here's another easy one. This is an easy one. Are you ready? Here you go. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. Who's got it? Let's see if anybody can get two. So far, we got a lot with one. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. What's that song? Got to get it. We got to get the name of the song fully correct to be right. That's the technical part of this tonight. This is, here we go. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. It's a very, most people would know the name of the song, but who's going to get it right? Oh, Tasha Bennett came strong. Boom, Tasha Bennett, height, broke it down, Battle Hymn of the Republic. Congratulations. Trish, in a close second, she would have been in the lead with two. But
Michelle, I would have probably said that.
Battle Hymn of the Republic. Very nice. Tasha with a point. Beauty by Drew. What? Morris.
Morris, that's great.
Are the lyrics? I got to look that up. Is that really the lyrics? Or he just? It could be. You never know nowadays. That's hilarious. Lee, Christina, how are you
Hi.
Doing?
That's
Welcome. Funny, Morris. That's funny. that actually was funny. All right. Okay, ready? Here we go. All right. What's wrong?
Nothing.
Okay. The next one. We only got a couple left. That Jesus Christ is born. That's a tricky one. It's an easy song, but it's not a lot. That Jesus Christ, if I sung it, you guys would easily get it. But yes. The lyric is that yes. Jesus Good Christ job. Is born.
I think your daughter got it.
That Jesus Christ is born. This is like watching, ready to see who's going to be. That Jesus Christ. Go yes. tell it on the mountain. This yes. is correct. Go tell it on the mountain mm-hmm. is correct.
So Bailey got it.
Bailey got it. So Good no job, one Bailey. So far, nobody has, according to Trish, it's go tell it on the twin. The Mount Twin. That's a good Trish song, really, Trish.
I can imagine she's texting me.
It's the Mount Twin. It's that Mount Twin. It's the Mount Twin that Jesus Christ was born. He was a great one. Go tell it on the Mount Twin.
Don't make fun.
I know, but I can tell her, man. Oh, spell check. Oh. Oh.
It's okay, Trish.
This is, all right.
I'm going to give it to you.
All right. This is good. Ready? Here we go. Joyful all ye nations, rise. Your internet is a cheater. I'm sorry. I can't. I don't know. This is just, it's random. It's like drawing out of a hat. Joyful all ye nations, rise. Joyful all ye nations, rise. All right, who is it? Joyful all ye nations, rise. You got to get the correct name, and you have to put the correct punctuation in this one, because it actually has some punctuation in this one. So, joyful all ye nations rise. You got to get the correct punctuation. There's a major punctuation mark in this title. Yeah, Babita, but you're missing. You got to get the full, closely in, but you're missing some punctuation. You guys are missing punctuation. Who's going to get it? Who's going to get it? You got to get the punctuation correct. Who's go? Oh, this is good.
This is
We've
good.
Got title. Lean on me when you're not strong. I'll be your friend. I'll be
Bring
there.
Bring in the cheese.
Oh, everyone. No, you got the punctuation backwards. Michelle got the name, but hers was punctuation was wrong. Yes.
After Hark.
After Hark. We'll give it to Trish because she came back with it. And Tasha gave it. So Trish and Tasha. Sister Act 2.
Yes, Trish.
This is
you lost me, brother.
That's hilarious. Eunice, what's up?
We missed you. Hello.
Sister Act 2. That has a great song at the end of it, by the way. Joyful, joyful Lord, we adore thee.
I knew you'd have to sing.
God of mercy, Lord.
No, God of glory.
Oh, I'm terrible. Lyrics are not my thing, Kate. Got it, man. By the way, what have you done for him lately? That's a great ending to a movie. Ooh, yeah. I told you. I knew I would get you singing by the end of the night. I just had to get your song. Look what I did. Look at that. Did you realize you were just going to sing? I knew it. Boom. I got you. Yes. Just had to get a little sister act in there. Okay. What have you done for me? That's great. He watches over everything so we see. I can't go that high tonight. It's been a lot of talking. That's a great ending to a movie. All right, one more, and I'll try to get one. I'll try to get one that's a little more, maybe. How about last one? Ready? Here we go. Calling, O sinner, come home. Calling, O sinner, come home. You know this song. Calling, O sinner, come home.
That sounds familiar.
It's very familiar, but it's just that lyric is tough. Calling, O sinner, come home. Last one. If I sung it, you would definitely know it. Calling, O sinner, come home. Come home. Nope. Nope. Not come home. Right at home? Nope. Come home? Nope. Nope, not it. Yes, come home. Calling, oh sinner, come home. Close, Leanne, close. Close. Very close. So calling, oh sinner, come home. Sing it. I can't sing it. I need it because if I sing it, they'll give it away. Sister Cheryl came strong, softly and tenderly. Jesus is calling. We're going to get the whole lyrics on here. Softly and tenderly. Yes, that's it. Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling. Calling, oh sinner, come home. Nice.
Pastor Jan.
This was fun because sometimes you know the song, but you don't know the real title.
Title. No, that is very true.
That is, and you know what's so funny? Guess what the next song on my list was? The next song on my list as it just reset. Hold on. Guess what the next song on my list was? Ironically, Joyful, Joyful, Lord, We Adore Thee. That was good. It's just, what a perfect way to do it.
A lot of fun.
We adore thee, God of mercy, God of glory.
Glory, Lord of life.
Lord of life. I'm going to get it, Kate.
Lord of life, love. Yeah.
I just know hearts unfold like flowers.
Before thee.
Before thee.
Hail thee.
Oh, no. very good. Anyways, we had some fun tonight. It was a lot of fun. We really, seriously, we mean this. What?
Oh.
What happened?
I was thinking 7 o'clock and the time.
Oh no!
We started. We went over our time.
No, it was 7:30. Anyways, okay. We really do try to have some fun, and I want to say this. Santa Claus is coming to town. Wow, this has been a night of musical lyrics. I will tell you that. This has been a musical lyric fest, and you want to know something, Kate? I am proud.
Why are you?
Because I resisted all of those. Yes. Hello, Darla. How are you? We hope you're feeling better.
Yes.
We're praying for you. We hope you're feeling better.
We send you our love.
Absolutely. Hope you're feeling better. I know it's a tough time, but we're praying for you. But you know how strong I was today?
Thank you, Anita. Those are kind words. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Anita. Yes, definitely. That's why really we try to do it. We really try to do it for that. We like to have some fun and just bring some light into the darkness of where we are in our world today. But I'm very proud of myself. I need a pat on the back. Do you know how hard it was to resist all the lyrics on the screen tonight?
Oh, I do. I actually, you know what?
I'm telling you, Kate. I fought. You didn't have a pat, not a smack. Goodness gracious. I'm going to need to ice my back now.
I'm sorry. I was patting. That was a little
passionate.
You're
fired up about the pat, man.
Sorry.
I had so much resistance to the lyrics tonight. And there were so many good lyrics.
Oh,
thank you, Morris. Yes. Appreciate it, man.
Thank you, Dahlia. Thank you.
Brick House to say goodbye.
Lori!
She's a...
Lori!
Wow.
Lori! Come on, you guys!
Oh, that's a good one, Vic. You. That's a great one. Wow, we that's a great you. One. Sweet Caroline.
Okay, that's safe. Da, da, da.
Good times never seem so... Oh, that's what we got to do. Come on, everybody. Hold on 1 second. I know. I'm going to probably get a call. What is it?
She's still singing Brick House.
She's mighty, mighty, letting it all hang out.
Oh, my
She's
Lord.
A brick house. Hey. She's
we are fired. This may be it our last... Out. Night, you guys.
That's it.
We're done.
It's good to have you. God bless you. We're now resigning or getting fired tomorrow. It was nice to be with you. The Brick House took us down.
Gosh, Lori Alders.
It was.
Lori.
Wow. Thank you. God help me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father.
If we're... See, they're not going to know.
Wow.
We're not going to be scheduled for next week. So
yes.
If we're not on the week if after,
we're, yes, we're not
know.
On next week. We haven't been
you're
fired, but if we're not on the next week, that's it, folks. It's done.
Yeah, Trish, it's done.
We're tapping done. Out. We're good. We're done. I got a phone call somewhere along the line saying, this is it. Thank you. Right at Home is now officially canceled. The Brick House has brought down the house. Look at all that. Look what we're doing, Kate. We're blowing. Oh, look. Debbie. Oh! Oh, that's awesome! Oh! This is awesome! Yes!
I know, Kim.
This is the best! Oh! This is good!
Thank you, Charmaine. Please,
you know what's going to happen next time? We're going to go with Casey and the Sunshine and shake your groove thing, shake your groove thing. Uh-oh. Oh, show me how to do it now.
All right, we're good.
Oh, man. So, real quick, one time, everybody together, just because it's derailed to the point we can't get it back. Charmaine is now literally just blowing up with the monkey thing. Blame it on the virus. That's it. True, Anita. That's it. That's it. The virus got me. The virus got me. But in response to that, we all love y'all very much. Everybody, together, one time, just because this is just where we are.
Where it began.
Yes. Take us home, Neil. Take us home. We love you guys very much. But then we hope you have a wonderful 4th of July. Safe. We won't be on next week.
No.
But
we may not be on forever.
Ever. This could be it. The Commodores and the Brick House have brought down Wright at Home's house. But Neil Diamond's going to take us home tonight. Little Sweet Caroline. Because we have derailed at this point. There's no getting it back. But we love you.
We love you guys. Touching
hands. Yes. Reaching out.
Reaching out.
Touching you.
Touching
me. That's it. Everybody sing along. We love you. Sing along. Right at home. Sign.